Good day and happy Saturday and welcome to December. Today's topic, you're all aware of it, is role of role models in your life. I have this habit of checking out, particularly with youngsters, students, people who come to us for career guidance. One of the things that I ask them is, who is your role model? I also do it with our DCS students. The first questionnaire that I give them when they come to enroll is, who is your role model? I get such a wide variety of responses. Some ask straight away, do I need to have a role model? Why should I have a role model? Some others say that I don't have one role model, but anybody and everybody whom I like, whom I admire, automatically becomes my role model. Then there are some very interesting people who say, I don't need role models. I am my own role model. Many people, I think, have really not understood the concept of what is a role model. I looked up a lot of definitions. I always do that whenever I'm taking up some topic to discuss. I found many of them. One of them I thought I'll share with you, and that is people, one or more people, dead or alive, known or unknown, whose characteristics or path you like to emulate. So that is what is a role model. Now let's understand that I can admire a lot of people. I can really look up to a lot of people. I can literally worship people who are so saintly and who are so godly, but they need not necessarily be role models. A role model is a person whom I look at, analyze, understand, and I find that the path which this person has gone on in life or the characteristics that this person has are worth emulating. That means I can do something similar, not the same. Please remember that. A role model is an inspiration to get myself motivated. In fact, long back I had told you this, I repeat that when Siddhartha heard Gautama the Buddha, after years of hunting for enlightenment, and he found that Gautama the Buddha is the enlightened soul, the first thing he did after that is to pack up and start moving. When his best friend asked him, don't you agree that Gautama the Buddha is an enlightened soul? He said, yes. Don't you think what he has said is amazing? He said, yes. Then why don't we sit here and become his pupils? Why are we moving on? And Siddhartha was supposed to have said, because Gautama did not become the Buddha by listening to lectures or sermons. It came from within. Now that I have met the Buddha and seen the Buddha and heard the Buddha, I know that it is possible to get enlightenment, but I will get enlightenment in my own way. And I shall continue my journey of looking for and experiencing enlightenment. Now you see the difference? There are a lot of people who would say Buddha is my role model. So I'll keep on, you know, listening to his sermons or reading about his teachings and this and that. But that's not a role model. That is a teacher, a guru, a mentor. You can have many gurus and you can learn a lot from many gurus and teachers and mentors. But a role model does not necessarily play the role of a guru or a teacher. The role model's life itself becomes something which you look upon and say, hey, I'd like to do something like that. And the most important thing, I know I can do it because I have evidence that this person has done it. So when you understand that somebody had to really struggle against all odds and that person succeeded, you get that reinforcement. You feel positive. You feel motivated that, yes, here is a person in life, in flesh and blood. If he has done it, I can also do it. That is what primarily is a role model. And as I said, your hero, your mentor, your guru, your teacher need not be a role model. And the role model need not even communicate with you, because the role model's life and, you know, characteristics are what you are going to emulate. At the same time, let us understand that we sometimes set up very unrealistic role models. We look at somebody and we say, oh, this person is such a great hero. This person has achieved so much. He is my role model. Now, if you ask him, are you willing to go on the same path? No. Two classic examples would be Mahatma Gandhi or Mother Teresa. Whenever somebody says, Gandhiji is my role model, I tell them, okay, are you willing to give up all your, you know, wealth and comforts? Are you willing to wear half a dhoti and start walking around all over the country? Are you willing to bear the lathis of the oppressors and the British or whoever it is and not retaliate? Are you willing to give up even basic food and eat just the minimum amount of food that is required for your sustenance? No. Then how can Gandhiji be your role model? The same way, there's a lady who says, Mother Teresa is my role model. Are you willing to give up your family? Are you willing to, you know, go and become a nun or a person who has given up on all, you know, worldly things and go and live in that nunnery and do service? No. So you can admire, you can, you know, learn so much from all these great people. You can even hero worship them. But your role model has to be somebody who, as I said, becomes your inspiration. Then comes the question, as I told you, which some people ask, do I really need to have role models? No. I don't think everybody has to have a role model. But it helps. It's like one of those basic skills. Do I really need to know how to drive a vehicle or ride a cycle or a bike? No. You can live your whole life without learning it. But if you have that skill, it can be very, very useful at times. So many skills like that, which may not be necessary, but which can really give a boost to you, starting from education itself. There are great people who have never gone to school or college. In fact, they became saints. So many saints and gurus and all that never went to school. Some of them could not even know how to read and write. So, is it necessary for me to get an education? No. But getting an education takes you miles ahead on the same journey which you have chosen. It is like, instead of walking, I have a cycle, or I have a motorcycle, or I have a car, or I have a bus, or I have a train. Obviously, my journey is going to be smoother, faster, and more convenient. So, if somebody presents me with a cycle or a motorcycle, but if I say, I can't ride it, I have never learned, you have to put it aside and you have to slowly start walking and trudging and facing whatever hardships you come across, because you are walking your way through the journey. That is why I say, look around. You will find innumerable people whose characteristics or whose way of choosing the path you would like to emulate. There are so many around you. They could be big historical figures who have done something great in life and are already dead and gone. There could be live people who are celebrities, who are leading their life in such a way that you feel, hey, maybe I should also follow on this path. And they could be your own near and dear. You may have a school teacher who can be a role model to you. You can have so many such people. Maybe your grandfather can be a good role model to you. The basic idea of having a role model, as I said, is that now you can see that yes, somebody has achieved something and therefore it is possible to achieve that. Without a role model, you are unsure. Will I succeed? Will I reach a goal? Will I be able to progress? But when you have a role model who has done it before you, then you know that yes, at least this example is there. Whether that person is dead or alive, it need not matter. Then the other question, which as I said, some people say, why do I need others as role models? I am my own role model. Good for you. I have nothing to comment on that. But do you realize that looking inward and looking only at your own skills and characteristics, you are missing out on so many other people. You're closing doors. It's like you're going on a journey, but you decide to close your eyes and keep walking. How much you will miss out because you're closing your eyes? Now that is what I'm saying. If you want to be your own role model, you're giving up innumerable people who could have been such a great inspiration to you. And also remember, sometimes somewhere you make a mistake. You have a setback. You do something which you are guilty or ashamed of. Now what happens to your role model? You're feeling bad about what you are doing. So you are no longer a hero to yourself. But you had said, I am my own role model. Life cannot always be smooth, no? And that is why I go on insisting that you need to be aware that by looking at role models, there is so much that we need to learn from them. Youngsters of today, unfortunately, do not seem to have in the public realm many role models. And they don't seem to be very impressed if they have a grandfather who was a school teacher but who sacrificed his whole life for the cause of education, and he gave such a good holistic upbringing to so many children over the years that he taught. They don't consider that great. On the other hand, they will say such and such sports person who has gone to international level of sports and who's making tons of money and who's being admired by everybody, he is my role model. The sad part is, many a time you don't even know what he is in real life. You really don't know what sort of a human being he is. Yes, he's got a skill. Be it a film star, be it a sports person, they have a skill. That's why they've gone up so high. And it is that skill which gets them recognition, wealth, admiration. But are they really the type of human beings that you would like to be? They may have many flaws. They may be unhappy. Haven't you heard of celebrities committing suicide at the peak of their life? So what does it show us? That just by having exceptional talent, just by you know, making money or just by becoming famous and popular, does not mean that I am leading a life which is commendable and which you can emulate. That is what I feel sad about, that so many people have role models without knowing what they are and what they do. Without knowing them as human beings, they look at only that one characteristics. He is in world championship, or he is the most popular movie star, or he is this or that. Therefore, he is my role model. One interesting thing we did, when we had picked up this topic, I asked my colleagues, I said, can we just check with people of different ages, starting with youngsters who are at a very basic level, who are now, you know, at the crossroads where they are going to carve out their own path, career, all these things, going up to people who have seen enough of life and who have achieved something. And we asked them, who are your role models? We got a very diverse range of responses, as I was telling you in the beginning itself. We selected three or four out of them. And I thought very quickly, I'll present these people to you. So we have, you know, this very short video clips, which Sonal has made and Anisa made. Here you are. See the first one, what she has to say.
My role model is Virat Kohli. So I recently heard a life story about him, and it said a lot about like about how he overcame his father's death, and like he came across a lot of like players and he improved himself. So he was it said like in 2012 his dad passed away like all of a sudden, and like He had a match to go for, and he went like he was like totally focused. He did not like let his like personal life distract him, and like that's something which really motivated me. Like you have like a lot of problems in your personal life, but instead of focusing on them, you're focusing on your goal, on getting better. And like his passion was cricket, so he focused a lot on that and improved. And 2011. He focused a lot on his fitness and strength because he thought his game was lagging behind. And like so he gave like 8 months of training, like total training and dedication with proper fitness and like proper diet and everything. And he came up to be such a good like player on the field.
Think it over. Think it over. You may agree, you may disagree. You may think she's very immature and she's getting glamorized by somebody. But you will also think that by having a role model, whether it is true or false, the incidents of his life, how they inspire a youngster, how she looks enthusiastic and she feels positive, her motivation goes up. That is how we thought, you know, to understand the concept and the importance of role models. Okay, now you saw a youngster. Let's see somebody who has had a little more experience of life. And let's see what they have to say about their role model.
Hi, my role model is my amma. The reason is like her simplicity, her ability to connect to any people from all walks of life, whatever it is, without any caste, creed or anything, which I am really struggling to do in my life, which I hope I can do that, keeping her as my role model. Thank you.
Fantastic. Now you see, at the one end, there was a celebrity, somebody, you know, who has become very popular and very well known. On the other side is a very simple lady, Ratna's mother. Nobody outside the family would know her. Nobody would list out her characteristics as something great to be imbibed or to be followed. But the mother acts as a stimulant and inspiration to Ratna when she says, even at this age, I'm trying to follow. But you see that effort which is going on? Why is she making that effort? Because she has this role model in front of her. All these years, she has been watching her mother, the characteristics, how she overcame difficulties, how she deals with difficult situations in life. Let's come back to another youngster and see what he has to say.
Today, I'll be talking about my role model, who is Dr. Jordan Peterson. So he's a psychology professor, and his book has guided me in achieving new goals and prioritizing and positioning myself for success. So following his advice, I prioritize honesty and enhancing my quality of life and embrace personal responsibility, not only for myself, but also for those around me.
Yeah. See, as a budding psychologist, Prashant obviously looks to see what psychologists do, what are the great achievers, what do they do? And he reads this book and he gets motivated. He hasn't met his role model. He's not likely to meet his role model in the rest of his life. He only reads his book and realizes that this man has a message to give, which I can imbibe and not only improve my quality of living, maybe my skills in order to do well in my chosen profession and stuff like that. So this was another example. Now let's go back to another very young girl who has just finished her 12th standard.
So I have two role models, and one of my role models is Ali Uncle for psychology and helping children in need of like autism and like LD, which most of all of our kids in Gurukul have. And my piano teacher, whose name is Sir Krenna, he teaches me piano and he's a professor in my college. And both of them have really inspired me to put music and psychology together and create something which can help children with autism and other children in like LD to express their emotions. So I'm doing an internship with that. So they have really helped me out. Thank you.
Yeah. Believe me, I didn't expect that Rini will take my name, otherwise I won't have used her for this. But keeping aside that she spoke about me, let's understand two role models. In two different vocations, with two different skills, two different backgrounds. And she looks up at both of them and says, can I combine these two? And that is what she is already doing. She is right now interning in a school for special children where she uses music and psychology to help these children who cannot otherwise communicate to bring out their inner emotions, to acquire a skill and stuff like that. To be able to do that, for a young girl to give up much more well-paying and lucrative professions and get into something like music and psychology, needs that motivation and inspiration which comes from role models. That is what I'm trying to tell you. And as I told you, as you saw, even in these examples, your role model can be your own mother. It could be a psychologist. It could be a music teacher. It could be a great, cricket star. It could be just about anybody. It doesn't matter. And also, you need not have one role model. You can have more than one. You can have as many as you want. And you can keep changing. When you learn something about a person and you say, no, I didn't know this aspect of it. I don't think this guy is a very great person. The way he has led his life, I didn't know these aspects. So I will knock him off. Makes no difference. Nobody is bothered. Nobody will question you. You knock off that person as your role model and acquire somebody else. And this is the reason why I mentioned that one should not get carried away by public life. Ratna has been seeing her mother from the time she was a small baby. So she knows exactly what her mother is. Everything, good, bad, ugly, everything she knows. And when she says that she is my role model, she's talking with in-depth understanding. But when you talk about celebrities, you cannot be sure that behind that glamour and this and that, what sort of human beings they are, what sort of life they are leading. One of the ways to find out about human lives and to, get inspired by them and all that is to read biographies. I'm a very ardent fan of biographies. I have read biographies of sports people, of the people who have been in the film world, people who have been in politics and diplomats, and people who have been gurus and masters. People who have been military leaders, every one of them without exception, whenever I come across a biography, I just grab at it. And the more I read about different types of human beings, past or present, the more I understand the width of human behavior and the easier it becomes for me to select who is going to be my role model. There's one thing which I give a lot of importance to, and that is people who are great achievers, they can definitely be, you know, an inspiration, but I somehow tend to admire people who have very great skills and abilities, and they pass on those skills and abilities to others. They teach others. They motivate others. They clear a path for them to follow. There are, for example, excellent sportsmen who have done great things in life. But there are also sportsmen who have, after doing everything great in life, they have helped others. Whenever I talk to my friend Ganesh, he always, you know, really adores Rahul Dravid. And when I had asked him initially, why only Rahul Dravid as a cricket fan? You've seen so many cricketers. He says, no. The way he passes on the message, the way he coaches people, the way he inspires people. I have not seen any of the top cricket players doing that. And that is why he's my role model in various ways. Now, people like Ganesh cannot give up their profession, vocation, and become a cricket player. But using the methodology of that person, that he is using that skill for something else, today Ganesh is doing the same thing. He is using his skills, his knowledge to inspire others, which is nothing to do with sports. So you see how role models can actually help you, even if you are in a totally different environment or profession or vocation, or even if you're a homemaker or a grandmother or whatever you are. So that is where I would like to ask you one very critical question. Do you think you are a role model to anybody? Has your life been such? You may have any qualifications, skills, designations, wealth, popularity, whatever it is. But do you think you have been able to inspire even a few people? You don't need large numbers. You don't have to be a role model to, you know, millions of people. Ratna's mother may be a role model to her daughter or her son or a few people like that. That's good enough. But you really need to ask yourself this question, that are you living your life in such a way that at least some people will look up at you and say, hey, this person can be one of my role models. This person has certain characteristics and has chosen a path which act as an inspiration to me, which motivates me to go ahead and do things. And if you do have that skill, please interact with people who are younger than you, and without sermonizing, without giving them lectures, help them to understand by choosing such and such path, by acquiring these type of characteristics or skills, what satisfaction you get, what fulfillment you get, more than money or wealth or, you know, popularity. What is it that from your inner side you get that feeling that, yes, I have, you know, lived a good, satisfactory life? If you have that in you, believe me, your life is worth living. So with that, let me take my 1 minute break. Anis is here to update you quickly on what's happening in Banjara, and I will be back.
Good afternoon, all of you. Once again, welcome to our Facebook Live talk. Next Saturday, yes, we will all be there at the Helping Hand Annual Day function, which is happening at IIT in the morning from 10:30 to till lunch. And it'll be a very nice moment where, you know, we all will enjoy there. And just a thing wanted to tell you, if anybody who is having some time who would like to give back to, you know, help others, they can come there that day or register themselves. They can come to the academy, know more about help, this one helping hand, how they can do. Our volunteers are spread across nearly 10 to 12 hospitals and where they're doing a good work. Then comes this month-end camp, which we have. The last camp we completed, and then there were people who were asking for another camp, and so we are going to have the month-end camp very soon in the month of February. So that is going on, and plus our everyday free counseling, which is there, that's happening there. So anybody who can, you know, who would like to have their counseling sessions done, it might be personal or career or anything, they just need to come to Banjara and, you know, have their sessions done, which is all confidential. And if they fix up an appointment and come, well, that's all the more better, where the counselor will be waiting for them. They can come and have a talk with them. And after that, the important thing, all are welcome to Banjara. Come sit with us, chat with us. And, you know, in case we have some work, we'll be shamelessly giving you to help us out also. You can have a cup of tea with us. Come down and see how Banjara is now. We have a total, you know, classes going on, the sessions going on, and even really you will enjoy. Again, you will remember your old days. Bring your friends along with you. Let them also enjoy. So next, the question hour session. Sir is back.
Yes, I'm back. And as I said earlier also, this is the part of the Saturday sessions which I enjoy most, because I get to learn so much from all of you. So we already have a number of comments and questions. We'll start with our dear friend Surekha, who always has something interesting to contribute to any topic that we take up. Surekha says, my mother, who was widowed very young, her words still ring in my ears. Believe in yourself, she said. Have faith in your abilities. Without that, you can neither be successful or happy. Whenever I face pain and confusion in my life, I remind myself, my mother had nerves of steel, and so do I. That's the beauty of it. When you have such a strong role model as your own mother, then you learn. And as Surekha says, I shall not give in under this pressure. Hats off to you, Surekha, and to your mother. Yes, we have Sridevi, who says, I thought Roshan was next after Surekha. So, okay, Sridevi says, yes, I do have several role models whom I look up to and get inspired by their achievements and their certain qualities. Yes, and it's a continuous process, Sridevi. You have to constantly do, as I told you, you may even drop some role models when you learn a little more about them. No, they're not all that great. Or when I was a youngster, you know, I was an adolescent, that time I used to look up to X, Y. But now as a more mature person, I look up at somebody else. When I come to the sunset years of my life, I look at somebody totally different, because my whole purpose in life changes. But every time, these role models can give you something to think about, something to move on to. Who is next? Katrona says, my role models are my mother's mother, that is my grandmother, and my father. Both are no more. My grandmother taught me a lot of household chores, and she was a wonderful person. My father was a great inspiration to me. That's what I was telling you, no? Sometimes it could be very simple people who have led very, very so-called ordinary lives, but they have left their imprint behind. As she said, both of them are no more. But today, they are remembered by Katrona and maybe a few more people who have learned something from them. Surekha also says, how can we learn from the mistakes or shortcomings of bad role models and use them as valuable lessons for personal growth? Excellent question, Surekha. Sometimes it is good to, you know, study bad people. Bad is just a sort of misnomer. People who I do not appreciate, people who have not really led the type of life that I would like to lead. So there's something or the other to learn from them also. No? What to avoid, what not to do. Maybe I had a parent or an elder whose behavior was really sad, which pained me, which disturbed me. If I can make a note of it. See, I don't have to be angry with them. I don't have to hate them. Whatever their reason they did, whatever their causes of their behavior is okay. But since their behavior was such that it caused harm to somebody, it caused pain to somebody, including me, perhaps, I can still use them as means to understand what I should not do in life. What is it that hurts people? I do that since I have to do a lot of public speaking. Whenever I come across a speaker whose speech is absolutely pathetic, who puts off people, who puts people to sleep, or who talks things which don't make sense at all, I make a mental note of it. Not criticizing that person, but saying, this is what I need to avoid. Tomorrow, I should not be making the mistakes which this person is making. And you see how my life improved, my skills improve. Next is, again, Surekha. One of my powerful role models is an illiterate farmer called Akram. He faced the fourth stage cancer courageously and won over it. He taught me that every day presents opportunities for us to be heroes in our own lives and to seize command over any situation. Thanks for bringing that to our attention, Surekha, because these Akrams are all unsung heroes. I have a very similar person who looked after our farm, which eventually became Manthan, for 32 years, Kadiraya. Kadirappa spent 32 years of the best part of his life looking after Manthan, where we go now and have such great, you know, get-togethers and workshops and all that. Last year, in September, he passed away. And believe me, while I felt extremely sad, I did not mourn his death. I celebrated his life. He has been a great role model to me. How a person at the lowest level of, you know, the economic strata can still lead such a wonderful life. Roshan says, my late parents are my role models. I have imbibed certain qualities or characteristics from them, like being always cheerful, hardworking, reaching out to others genuinely, that now I have become a role model to others. That is what the process is supposed to be. When a person is a good role model to you and you imbibe their qualities, you start becoming a role model. There's a ripple effect. You know what your father and mother did, Roshan, now even long after their passing away is continuing to flow through you and to reach so many people who never knew them. That is the beauty of having good role models in your life and to appreciate them and to imbibe their characteristics. Anjana says, yes, mothers have said and appreciated and would like to bring up their children the way I did. Yes, exactly. There are people watching you. There are people who are, you know, analyzing you. There are people who want to see what sort of life you have led, what you have done, and what was the impact of it. They may not even come and tell you that you have been a role model to them. but the effect is there. You have achieved something. Madhu says, my role models are my late parents who had 7 lovely children, and they brought us up very courageously, obviously, with positive response and keep going on. Life is beautiful because of her parents. That is the legacy that we need to leave behind. So let us make it a chain reaction. Learning, imbibing, and becoming part of our role models in such a way that automatically we become role models to others and people look up to us. Maybe even we are dead and gone, right? That is how it goes. Surekha says, what steps can I take to develop my own self-awareness and critical thinking skills, enabling me to remain grounded when evaluating role models? Yes, that's a good question, Surekha. We need to keep ourselves aside. If we become defensive, or if we focus on ourselves, yes, I'm also being nice to my children, no? Yes, I'm also being a good parent. Yeah, I'm doing this, no. When you are looking up to your role models, be it your own parents, be it a celebrity, be it whoever it is, for that moment, allow yourself to disappear. Just sit and analyze what that person is doing or has done. Check out which you can imbibe and which you cannot imbibe. And remember, every role model need not be a perfect human being. The person may have some good qualities, some bad qualities. Knock off the bad qualities. Take only the good qualities and continue with that. When you do that, keeping yourself away, you will be able to really imbibe. If you still have doubts, no, have a buddy system, a partner with you, and say, I am analyzing my father as a role model, or I am analyzing this celebrity as my role model. This is what I feel about them. And if you bring yourself into the picture, yeah, I am doing this because of that. Your friend can tell you, sorry, keep yourself out. We are discussing that role model. We are not discussing you. And once, twice, three times you are corrected, then your thought process becomes very smooth. Anjana also says, I have role model from sports, housewives, friends who are absolutely behind how they have worked upon themselves to be there where they wanted to be. Learning from my life mistakes. Yes, Sajana, that is what I told all of you also. You need not have one role model. You can have many of them. And the wider the range of people, one role model of yours is a sports person. One role model of yours is a housewife. One role model is a good parent. You get so much of wider and holistic learning from each one of them. And that makes you a composite and a complete person. Amina says, what if one never had any role models at all? How does one get to shape his or her life? I want to just correct you a little bit here, Amina, by telling you, it is impossible that you did not have role models. Just look around and see. The same way as, you know, Surekha told about an ordinary farmer called Akram. How did she get to identify him as a role model? She could have just said, he's an ordinary fellow, he's a farmer, he's a coolie, he's whatever it is. Okay, sometimes we even take pity and say, okay, I'll give him some extra money so that, because he's so poor. No. If you start observing all around you, believe me, not only Anjana, but all of us, there are so many wonderful role models around us. It is up to us to recognize them and identify them. Madhu says, also from Banjara, I learned a lot about emotions, how to handle your life. And I have gratitude to all Banjara team because I brought up my sons after what I learned from there. Thank you. Thank you for sharing, Madhu. Because here you are, an entire team called the Team Banjara. And you see that cohesion, you see that teamwork, you see the harmony with which they were. That itself is a role model to so many people. So many people come and, you know, appreciate, and they say, when I come to Banjara, it doesn't look like it's an office or an establishment or something. It feels so homely. And that also is something that we can imbibe. We can say, tomorrow, can I also create that environment, either in my office or in my home or in my family or wherever? Savita says, good afternoon, Banjara team. Thanks, Savita. Good afternoon to you also. Sridevi says, my late father's unconditional love towards me is the motivation to become my children's role model of unconditional love. Yes, this is exactly what I was saying. Need not have very great characteristics. In fact, Sridevi has also written, my dad was an alcoholic, but also a sweet dad for me. That is important. It's so easy to label somebody, you know, oh, he's an alcoholic, he's a drunkard, he's this or that. We should keep away from that. That's what I was telling you, that there's always something good to learn from somebody if you overlook the negative qualities of that person. Nobody can be a saint or a Mahatma with perfection. Everybody's got their flaws. In fact, many good role models are people who have become what they are because of certain drawbacks, because of certain mistakes that they made. There's a very good proverb which says, every saint has a past and every sinner has a future. That should be our outlook. Surekha says, one of the most powerfully impacting role models in my life has been you, Ali. Oh my God. Thanks. I'm really, really, you know, touched. You have inspired me to live a life of growth, of learning, and of contribution. Yes, Surekha. I want people like you to carry that flag forward. Whatever people like me have done, and we will leave that thing and go. I'm sure there is Surekha and there are so many others who will be the torchbearers and who will take the flag ahead. And that will give me more satisfaction than anything that I have personally achieved. Wow, Sridevi is adding to that saying, yes, East or West, Dr. Ali and team have always been the best. I hope also in North and South. Kumar is here, right from our old DCS 2006, you know, more than 17 years back. Kumar says, thanks for today's nice topic. My question is, ideally, how many role models can an adolescent keep? What are the key areas he has to first keep in mind too before selecting role models? There's no limit to the numbers, but yes, if every second person you start making a role model, then you yourself will get confused. One thing that you need to do, particularly youngsters who are looking for, you know, acquiring role models, is to, you know, identify their own goals. I want to be a sports person. I want to be a writer. I want to be a psychologist. I want to be a good software engineer. I want to be a good son to my parents. Once you understand what are the areas of priority in your life, based on that, you can start identifying who are the people who have already achieved what I am aspiring to achieve. So I will focus more on them. I will analyze them. And I will get inputs from them, whereby I can be a good role model to others, as well as to improve my own quality of life. Surekha says, one of my favorite role models passed away today. Oh my, my 94-year-old mommy would always pray, God, don't give me a lighter load. Grant me a stronger back. What an inspiration. We all pray to God saying that, make things easy. Give me a lighter load. Don't, you know, burden me. But here was this wonderful mommy of Surekha who said, grant me a stronger back. Give me troubles. Give me burdens, but give me a stronger back. I want to carry those things forward. Her life was a serial disaster. Mommy was a blockbuster hit. Yes, I'm. Can truly visualize how she must have been. Oh, Parvin also says, Ali, you are one of my role models. Thanks a lot. Parveen, I get really touched when people say these things, though I feel that I'm a very, very ordinary and a humble person. But yes, if I have been in some way directly or indirectly instrumental in giving you that inspiration and motivation, I accept your compliments with humility and with gratitude. Ah, Sridevi says, yes, sir. Everywhere like omnipotent God, Banjara, the bestest. No, no, let's not compare Banjara with God and all that. But yes, we do try to do our level best. It's a continuous process, whenever, whatever, in whatever way we can, we do. And it's the entire Banjara team, I can tell you, right down to the most humble people, the lady who comes and cleans up our rooms and our bathroom, she also has a very significant contribution to what the team Banjara does. Parvin is asking, we can have role model at any age, right? Yes, Parvin, right? Not only we can have at any age, sometimes our role models change as we go up in age. Our priorities change, no? Like I was telling about youngsters also, if they have certain goals and certain priorities, accordingly they can choose role models. Now your priorities change, your goals change, your thinking changes as you grow older, and to lead the latter part of your life happily and with fulfillment, you obviously need role models who are fulfilling what you are looking for, isn't it? That is how it should be. Madhu says, yes, after getting educated from Banjara, I'm more confident and taught my sons not to give up, and beautifully they are taking care of their own personal life and family. Yes, Madhu, that is how what I was saying earlier, the ripple effect. One passes on the baton to another, another passes on the baton to somebody else. We don't even know how people get benefited. There are so many people who benefit from you and you may not even know it. But if you know that you are doing the right thing, you can sit back confidently that yes, somewhere somebody is getting inspired by me. Surekha says, one of the most powerfully impacting role models in my life has been you, Ali. You have motivated me to live a life of growth and learning and of contribution. Please, all of you are somehow thinking that was not the idea of having this topic. I humbly accept your appreciation with deep gratitude, but I still say that I'm a very simple and a humble person. Madhu says, it was very difficult to live life as a single parent and totally brokenhearted, but was very hopeful. You noticed that Madhu has ended with hope, and that is what drives people ahead. And good role models also give you hope. Like I told you in the beginning, that when you see that somebody has struggled, has overcome, has achieved, has succeeded, or even has, you know, born with fortitude, whatever misfortunes came for them, that builds up hope. One of the greatest benefits of having a role model is that it enhances your hope about the future. Surekha says, my mother was extremely principle-centered. She used to say, nothing is free. If you don't work hard for it, you don't get it. There are no free lunches. There are no excuses for not doing the right thing. What a wonderful education Surekha's mother left behind for her. More than any higher level of, you know, training, some MBAs and some PhDs and whatever it is, more than that, this is what a parent can leave behind for a child, or even any other role model can leave behind for a child. And as Surekha said, there is no free lunch. And believe me, if somebody gives you free lunch, there is a different price tag attached to it. That person will extract his pound of flesh. And why do you need free lunch? You can afford your own lunch, isn't it? So why do we even accept if somebody is giving us free lunch? We say, give it to somebody who is so poor that he cannot afford to eat. And this I'm talking not just in the physical sense of lunch, but also in the mental and emotional sense of taking favors from somebody taking unnecessary help from somebody, somebody coming and saying, no, no, don't worry, I will take care of you. If there is even a 1% element of, you know, some vested interest or some backdoor deal involved in it, please keep away from it. Roshan says, some genuinely good doctors are my role models. Yes, who truly help patients and bring them to the mainstream to avoid humiliation from this society. Hats off to such great people who follow the path of helping patients to the maximum so that they can live normal lives. Yes, Roshan, such doctors are really not appreciated. They don't make big money. They don't have a queue of patients and this and that. So people don't think that they're very successful doctors. But if they have this type of attitude, which Roshan told us just now, they are indeed great role models. And role model need not be, you know, serving society need not be restricted to doctors. It can be teachers. It could be soldiers. It could be so many people who directly or indirectly are serving society in a helpless manner. And they are the wonderful and best role models that you can think of. And with that, we are coming to the end of the hour. So I don't want to, but I have to wind up. And I will leave you with the message that next Saturday, which is 9th, I am going to be in the IAT, Institute of Agriculture Technologies, where we are having our Helping Hand Annual Day and our common class for the current DCS batch. But I'm definitely going to take myself out for that hour between 2 and 3 and spend time asking you, how do you spend time with yourself and help you to introspect, to be able to question, and maybe if necessary, to set yourself on the right path. So see you on Saturday, the 9th of December at 2 o'clock with this question posed to you. How do you spend time with yourself? Thank you and bye-bye.
I recently heard a life story about him, and it said a lot about like about how he overcame his father's death, and like he came across a lot of like players and he improved himself. So he was it said like in 2012 his dad passed away like all of a sudden, and like he had a match to go for. And he went like, he was like totally focused. He did not like let his like personal life distract him. And like that's something which really motivated me. Like you have like a lot of problems in your personal life, but instead of focusing on them, you're focusing on your goal, on getting better. And like his passion was cricket, so he focused a lot on that and improved. And in 2011, he focused a lot on his fitness and strength because he thought his game was lagging behind. And like, so he gave like 8 months of training, like total training and dedication with proper fitness and like proper diet and everything. And he came up to be such a good like player on the field.
Hi, my role model is my amma. The reason is like her simplicity, her ability to connect to any people from all walks of life, whatever it is, without any caste, creed or anything, which I am really struggling to do in my life, which I hope I can do that, keeping her as my role model. Thank you.
So today I'll be talking about my role model, who is Dr. Jordan Peterson. So he's a psychology professor, and his book has guided me in achieving new goals and prioritizing and positioning myself for success. So following his advice, I prioritized honesty and enhancing my quality of life and embrace personal responsibility, not only for myself, but also for those around me.
So I have two role models, and one of my role models is Ali Uncle for psychology and helping children in need of like autism and like LD, which most of all of our kids in Gurukul have. And my piano teacher, whose name is Sir Krenna, he teaches me piano and he's a professor in my college. And both of them have really inspired me to put music and psychology together and create something which can help children with autism and other children in like LD to express their emotions. So I'm doing an internship for that. So they have really helped me out.